This is a review of Verizon Wireless's LG Dare, the latest in its line of touchscreen devices. The Dare smooth touchscreen interface really makes it Verizon's best touchscreen device to date. Looking at the main menu, we can click the envelope, which gives us our inbox for text messages. Notice at the top of the screen, you'll see a back button and a home icon. They're found on every submenu. Click on Inbox, it's a drop-down menu for us. If we click on the phone icon, it displays the on-screen dial pad. You can use the buttons on the screen, the voice command, or its advanced handwriting recognition to enter a phone number. You don't need a stylus, your fingertip will work fine. Let's go ahead and look at the program menu. You'll find a white background with scattered icons because of the theme I chose. You can choose a black theme that arranges tiles neatly in rows. Looking at settings and tools now. Let's go back and look at tools. You'll see the voice command, calculators, things of that nature. The Bluetooth menu allows you to add and show devices. You can actually send things with Bluetooth profile that's on the Dare from computer to your phone or to another phone even. Looking at sound settings, display settings, we've got backlight, banner, wallpaper. You can choose a static wallpaper or an animated wallpaper. You can adjust your clock and your menu fonts on the display settings as well. Look at some of the other settings here. See our phone settings. Call settings. With the touchscreen settings, you can calibrate the touchscreen, and you can also adjust the haptic feedback level. USB auto detect. Memory. And our phone information. Back from the menu, let's go ahead and take a look at settings and tools one more time, scrolling up and down, and then we'll go ahead and look at My Music, which syncs with Rhapsody if you have the VZ Music subscription. It recognizes album art. You can drag and drop from your desktop right to the device. Anything that's an MP3 or playlist recognized by Rhapsody. Right now, the Dare still has the older version of VZ Navigator. I understand we can expect an upgrade to the new version with traffic integrated very soon. Media Center is now replacing Get It Now. Same idea, just a new name. At messaging options. There's a blog option on the Dare that allows you to upload photos directly to a social networking site. I use it to upload to Flickr directly. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Dare's customizable shortcut menu. You can find the shortcut menu halfway up the screen on the right. You pick your most favorite items and add it to that menu. Let's go ahead and take a look at the browser now. We haven't done that yet. It's a very good experience with the Dare. When you turn the phone sideways, if I would have turned it all the way sideways, we would see it in landscape mode. We'll see that in just a second. We'll take a look at my website. It's optimized for mobile devices, so it'll render nicely on your cell phone. Loads very quickly with the EVDO and the Rev-A that the Dare offers. Now let's go ahead and take a look at a full screen display on the browser. It'll eliminate that menu bar at the bottom. And then we can choose three different display renderings. We can choose standard, which we've been looking at. We can choose screen optimized or text only. We're going to look at screen optimized. And we'll no longer scroll left and right. It's just up and down after we've chosen screen optimized. Very nice on a lot of local news channel websites to use that view. Looking at the shortcut menu, we're going to see that you can drag and drop the calendar from the shortcut menu right to your main menu. That's the calendar I'm dragging now. Right now, we're going to click on the notification menu. You can see I have a calendar event today. Calendar shows us weekly, monthly, or daily items. You can also search from the calendar. You can send both calendar and contacts if you're using the vContact or vCalendar file structure via Bluetooth from your phone to your computer and vice versa, or any other compatible Bluetooth device for that matter. This is our favorites for contacts. These are tiles from my photo IDs that you can drag and drop any way you want on screen. When you select a tile, you can click the envelope for messaging, the phone to make a call, or the information button to display the contact information. Now let's go ahead and look at the buttons on the DARE and the two slots. Looking at back now, has a nice feel to it, a non-slippery feel. It's almost like a rubber silicone texture. And we'll go ahead and take a look at the port for charging, which is micro USB. And we'll go ahead and take a look at the micro SD card slot. On top of the DARE is a 3.5mm headphone jack. It's great for using standard headphones or for tethering it to your home stereo or car stereo. Listen to your MP3s any way you want. Just click the voice command button here. Now we haven't looked at the DARE's most celebrated feature, which is its camera. It's a 3.2 megapixel camera. And the DARE's camera is much like your standard point-and-shoot camera, which is excellent for most people because it seems as though the last year or two we haven't seen too many great cameras on cell phones. You have autofocus, face detection, white balance, ISO adjustments, different modes, different settings. You can also edit your photos right on the phone, crop, adjust the lighting, things of that nature. There's also a built-in flash on the DARE. I don't know that we've seen that since the LG, I want to say 8000, which was my favorite LG phone before the DARE, favorite phone actually ever before the DARE. Flash is great because if you're in the auto modes, it will recognize the lighting for you and fire automatically. Can adjust shutter sounds. You can also shoot in bursts of 1, 3, 6, or 9. There's also a panoramic shot mode on the DARE, which is excellent. Now we're looking at the video camera, which also makes use of the flash and also makes use of editing right on board. And the DARE will ask you if you want, you can actually customize if you want to save it to be able to send your photo or your video or to save it to transfer directly to your desktop using the USB mass storage. Well, that wraps up our review of the DARE. The DARE is definitely worth looking into.